grace and glory of God be with you today. What a beautiful day it is to join together in worship. My name is Patrick Schultz. I'm the pastor here. It is a joy to be in worship with you. If you're worshiping with us virtually or online, I'm delighted to have you with us today also. A couple of announcements that I'd like to share this morning. Inside the bulletin is two inserts. One is a welcome card. I'd invite you to take a look at that. Let us know that you're worshiping with us today. There's a front and a back, and you can kind of read through that and see what's on each side. As you fill that out, you can just leave it on the pew next to you or on your way out. There's a basket that will be just outside our back door here that you can drop it in there. And then we have our Staying Close, Staying Connected. Give you a little bit of insight what's happening in the life of our church this week. There's a couple of birthdays and anniversaries I'd like to point out. So for birthdays this week, Chase Taylor, Ryan Athor, Alyssa Hess, Sherry Jump, Rachel Krause, Abby Sheldon, Ruby Jump, Betty Kellner, Austin Reisterer, and Peyton Char, Claire Clemens, John Lukow, Michelle Lukow, and Geraldine Schneider. Lots of birthdays this week. A couple of anniversaries, Brian and Wendy Henschel, and Richard and Alyssa Hess. If you see them, wish them a happy birthday or a happy anniversary, or perhaps send them a card, let them know that you're thinking about them. On the inside, a couple of things to note. Sunday school starts today, and we are so excited about that, and it's so good to see all the kids here this morning. We'll have a Sunday school teacher installation, and then a children's message, and then the children will be excused to go down to their Sunday school class. Tonight is the high school youth group meeting. We'll be here at St. Mark's. There is still need for an additional chaperone to be within our safe sanctuary parameters. And so if you are able to do so, contact Brenda here and let her know. We have the Chosen study group starting tomorrow. There's still room for more people. We have a 10 a.m. class and a 6 p.m. class here at St. Mark's. Just let me know if you're interested or write it on your welcome card that you would be interested. I'm going to invite you to read the rest of our announcements on your own. Also on that insert is a GPS, Grow, Pray, Study. There's some additional text that you can read to go along with today's message. A bit of commentary that I put together. And on the back, an area for notes that you might want to write down from our service today, whether the message or ideas or thoughts or prayer concerns or whatever. This is for you to use. I think that's it for announcements. I always like to look around to make sure I'm not missing somebody and wave their hand. But with that, I want to invite Lori to come up. She's a reader today. I'm delighted to have her here.
One announcement I can sink in with my time before you is I have the tickets for the United Churchmen and Women's Banquet coming up on Thursday, October 20th. It's going to be held at our Shepherd UCC in Howard's Grove. And the keynote speaker for the event is the Reverend Crystal Clemmy, pastor at First Congregational UCC in Plymouth. She's been the recipient of the scholarship in the past, and we'll be sharing about the impact that that has had in her ministry. So I invite you to join me in the call to worship printed at the bottom of our front page. God has called us to gather together as beloved children.
We come ready to share our authentic selves, our hearts with God and one another.
Wherever we are in our faith journey, God meets us right where we are, calling us out from isolation and fear into sacred community.
We come to humbly praise and worship the one who chose vulnerability for the sake of perfect love.
Lord, I'd like to invite our Sunday school teachers to come up. Join me as we have our installation. In this installation, we recognize our teachers and have a blessing for them. So we have Michelle Shaw, Anna Marie Branstead, Tara Van Dusky, and Brenda Schultz will be teaching. What grades will you be teaching? Middle school?
All the littles.
All the littles? All three of you teaching the littles. Wonderful. But teachers are called to serve in the church in a variety of roles, and this morning St. Mark's United Church of Christ affirms with deep appreciation the outstanding, faithful, and dedicated commitment to the task of teaching. As we do so, we understand that today's teachers stand upon the shoulders of those who came before, and the good works of these teachers will be building blocks for those yet to come. Gentle and loving God, through the ministry of teaching, we learn about you, your creation of humanity, your trust in us to be your people. We grow deeper in our understanding of you and our love of you and one another. To our Sunday school teachers, will you teach your students with gentleness, grace, love, and compassion? If so, answer, we will. Will you undertake your responsibilities as a teacher with integrity, striving always to pass on to each child the teachings of Jesus Christ? Will you pray for and nurture each child in their journey of Christian formation, church, Bible, God, Christ, and Spirit, and community? If so, continue to pray. And to the congregation, will you pray for these teachers, their classes, their students, encouraging them, supporting them, assisting them without complaint or hesitation, knowing fully the awesome responsibility each has in the teaching of our children? If so, answer, we will.
We will.
I hereby install and bless you as the 2022 and 23 Sunday school teachers for St. Mark's United Church of Christ, by the authority as pastor of St. Mark's and with the support of the consistory board and with the blessing of our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. And I want to invite now our young at heart to come up for the young at heart event. Bible school, and so it wasn't all that long ago that you get. Last month, that's right. I have a question for you. We're all afraid of something, aren't we? Yeah. Maybe it's spiders, or monsters, or the dark. When I was much younger, I was afraid of the dark. It's spooky. You don't know which monster or spider may be lurking. So I was a bit afraid of the dark. But people fear things all the time. And it can be anything, speaking in front of people. That can be a fearful thing. Trying something new. Saying hello to the new kid. Now that shouldn't be that hard, should it? Hello. See? Pretty easy. But a lot of people are afraid of making new friends. It's okay. It's about having the courage to face our fears. And a great thing happens when we face our fears and we say, take that fear, get out of here. I got this. What happens if we say that to our fear? Take that fear, get out of here. I got this. We feel a little bit better about ourselves, don't we? No? We got this. Let me tell you how this can make us feel better. We got this because we have someone on our side that is bigger than all the fear in the world. Do you know who that is? God. Absolutely. God's on our side. We're on God's side. And God tells us, don't be afraid. Have courage and strength. I am with you always. God's the greatest thing ever, right? And there's no one bigger than God. There's no one stronger than God. There's no one smarter than God. So with God on our side, what is there to fear? Take that fear. Get out of here. We got this. God and me. Let's pray. I invite you to pray along with me, okay? Great God of all things, give me courage when I am afraid. Give me strength when I am weak. Give me guidance when I'm lost. Thank you for all you do for all of us, Lord. Amen. Amen. God bless you, my friends. So I'm going to pass this around. I'm going to invite you to take one with you. Just pass it right on down. And then you're going to find your Sunday school teachers. They're going to find you and take you downstairs for Sunday school. To stand as you are able for our opening hymn, a hymn of praise, number 397 in the hymnal, O Holy City, Seat of God. Thank you. prayer of confession for all of us. And then I'll invite you to join together the words of assurance as they're printed in the bulletin. Let us pray. Gracious God, in the midst of difficult and challenging times, you remain Lord of all creation. We acknowledge how often we choose to depend upon our resources rather than depend upon you. Through the Holy Spirit, you send us courage, yet our fears continue to hold us. Through the Holy Spirit, you send us comfort, yet our unease still controls us. Through the Holy Spirit, you send us truth, yet our own wisdom still guides us. Forgive us and free us from our sin. Grow our trust and dependence upon you. Strengthen, encourage, and teach us. We pray through Jesus Christ. Together. Love, Lord, your love is remarkable. Despite our ongoing sin, you have graciously pursued us, forgiven us, and saved us.